Hello Dolphin users, now this video will teach you how to work with the Seagate Baud smartly. Now I have connected one Seagate desktop hard drive to its DFL SRP firmware repair hardware. Now I enter the Seagate firmware repair program. So here is the COM port. We can see there are a list of different baud rates available within the program. So the very first thing we need to do is to enable the COM port and then power off, power on the drive. We can see the messages reported by the COM terminal. Only if you have connected the COM cables and COM connector properly, and you will see such kind of hard drive reported messages. So this is from the internal environment of the hard drives. If these messages are not available, that means the hard drive may have kind of problem or the connection has something wrong there. Now let's try to use Ctrl Z and we can enter the F3T prompt. Only after we have entered the F3T prompt, we can input commands within the COM terminal. Because this is one 4TB hard drive and it's partially locked, so for some commands it cannot be executed directly. So we need to unlock the hard drive to enter the commands. Now, the course today, we will focus on the baud rate selection. So usually for this one, we use the standard baud rate 38400 for the F3 hard drives. But this one is mainly used to diagnose with different commands. If users want to work faster to operate on the firmware, especially when the hard drive is busy, users cannot operate within the ATM mode. So if the baud rate is low, the firmware operation will be very slow. But if users can select a higher baud rate, then the firmware operation will be much faster. So let's enter the program and we can check what kind of firmware operations will be affected by the baud rate selection. Now we can see the ROM operations. When users try to read ROM or write ROM, users need to use the COM port. If the drive is busy, we can only read and write ROM by COM mode. And also, like the read modules, tracks, and the SYS files. All these firmware operations will be affected by the baud rate selection. So, when the drive is busy, the baud rate selection of a higher baud rate is very important. Otherwise, users need to wait a lot of time to wait until the firmware operations complete. So right now we can try to select a higher baud rate and try. So sometimes we can select the baud rate directly, and we will see, for example, we have selected this one, 460800. So this is one very good one. However, at this time, we can find we cannot enter F3T anymore. That means it failed. So what to do to get it back to work normally? Now we can see we go back to the standard 38400. Then we can enter F3T prompt. So for this drive, because it's locked, so we need to unlock it first. We can use the common repair and unlock dial close mode. So for these two families, we can use this function to unlock it. And now we can try to enter the F3T prompt and use Ctrl L. If we use Ctrl L and the information is displayed here normally, that means the drive has been unlocked successfully. We can use Ctrl Z again to enter the F3T prompt. So at this time, we can try to select a different baud rate right now to use, for example, this one. So after we click this one, we can see we can enter the F3T prompt directing. So at this time, we can go to read as SYS file. So we can use COM port, we can use ATA. Only if the drive gets ready, so we can use ATA. But when the drive is busy here, then we can only use the COM mode. So let's try to test using COM mode to backup the SYS file. Now we can see, for example, we backup the SYS1B. Now we can see the speed is okay, but if you are still using the baud rate at 38400, the backup at this kind of baud rate will be very, very slow. So, this is very important to select a higher baud rate to backup. We can click stop. Ctrl V, we can enter the F3T. Let's try to select a much higher baud rate. For example, 1228. So, we can see this one is still available. So much higher baud rate. And let's try to execute these commands. See, we can still execute these commands. But please note, for such kind of a high baud rate, if we power off and power on, we cannot check the information inside. Let's try. So it's still okay. So only if you can access the drive with a higher baud rate, then users need to select a higher baud rate to try. When you power off and power on the drive, the baud rate will go back to the standard one to show the reported messages from hard drive inside. Now, sometimes if users select the baud rate directly and it failed, so at this time we can use one command called B command and then 460800. Then we can select, now we can disable COM port and select the baud rate and enable it and Ctrl Z. So we can go back and try again. We can use the B command to set the baud rate. Now let's do it again. 460800. See? Now we can select this one. Go back and try again. B460800. Thank you. we need to unlock. Please note the family name. Now Ctrl L, V40. Okay, so it works. B command. Try. Okay. So it's now set properly. So we need to make sure the backblows mode is unlocked first, and then you can use the B command. Otherwise, it doesn't work. So this is how we can select the baud rate, select a higher baud rate. So this is a higher baud rate. Then we can work with the firmware by COM mode. Even if the drive is busy, we can read the SYS file fast. SYS. Drive has some problem, so at this time we can select a higher baud rate. Unlock it again. So at this time, we need to go back. Power off and power on. So we need to first go to this one. So we need to unlock it first. Go to this one first. Okay, then we can select a higher baud rate, so it still works. Maybe this drive get a limit of 921600, so we can work within this baud rate to back up the SYS file. 1B. So the drive has some problem. Go to this baud rate first, and then go to a higher baud rate. Okay, so this is a much higher baud rate. Back up the SYS. Let's back up another 128. Now they can see the speed of backup is much higher right now. So this is how we can work with the baud rate smartly for Seagate hard drive. This one is very important. So baud rate, users need to understand it correctly. When users first enter the Seagate firmware repair program, users can use the 38400 as a standard one to show the reported messages from the hard drive inside. And next, users can use a much higher baud rate to back up the firmware modules, to back up and write the SYS files or other kind of firmware operations. Users need to select a much higher baud rate to work with. So this will enhance the firmware repair efficiency. So this one is very important. Now we can see, even if the drive is busy now, we can back up using the COM port without any problem, using this high baud rate. So thank you for watching this video.